Late last year, I informed both the House and Senate about this problem we were having. I'm glad they finally took it up and took it serious. And I do support this legislation because it does do exactly what we needed, was to repeal the ID, to repeal the law we passed on this floor in 2012, and it allows us to take another step. But I want to remind you that it's not over, because there's no guarantees that the federal government's going to give us an extension, as been stated up here on the floor and in the Senate. There's no guarantees. In fact, one of the high-ranking officials in Homeland Security earlier this year stated there will be no extensions after January of next year, and our driver's license will not be good for travel. So this is something we have to stay on top of, and this legislation now allows us to have that conversation. Within the amendments that the Senate did, they do mandate that there's a report due to us, all our leadership, and all our transportation chairmen and our state government committee chairmen, both minority and majority, to make certain that we do get in compliance. So I look forward to revisiting this after the summer, after we get the costs, because cost is important. Now, when we talk about getting a new license, there might be a fee tied into this new Real ID license. It might cost us $5 more. And the important part is about educating our constituents, because whether you have a son or daughter in Pittsburgh who may or may not get sick, you might have to fly out there because you chose the cheaper license, because we are giving our public the option, you chose the cheaper license, you may not be able to get on that plane. You might not be able to get on that plane. Now, hopefully, the department under Secretary Richards gets the extension in June, because if they don't extend us now in June, there's 283 federal facilities that we will not be able to enter with our driver's license. That's 283 places in Pennsylvania. So if someone's deployed and comes home and you want to visit your child or grandchild and say hello to them because they've been deployed for 2 years, you may not be able to get on there if they don't let us an extension. But there's no guarantees. The federal government has made us no guarantees that they will extend any deadlines. We're just hopeful. So today I stand in support of this hopeful legislation. Hope we can move forward and come in full compliance with the law that is to protect the public, not look over our shoulders, not put us in this big database that's been spoken about. It's supposed to help us. Help us. And just to note a fact, if anybody holds a commercial driver's license, some of the stuff that we don't comply with now, we do on our commercial size driver's license, to make certain that you have one license from one state, and the person on that license is that person. Because the stats show you, in the federal government, there's reports out there, Pennsylvania is one of the licenses that are mostly duplicated and falsified throughout the country, us in Florida. It's really big. We're an easy license to duplicate. We have college kids running all across the country with Pennsylvania licenses that they buy online, swipe it into bars, and go in. It's swipeable and everything. We have to upgrade our technology and make sure the public's safe. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.